this is the day that the Lord has made, CFC, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Well, we honor the Lord for another day that the Lord has blessed us with, and we are so glad for your presence joining us on this evening. Amen. It's Bible study time. Amen. And in just a few moments, we're going to open up in scripture, and then we're going to go before the Lord in prayer. We're going to receive the song of the Lord, and then we're going to hear the word of God on this evening. And I believe that there's a word for you on this evening. Listen, we want to encourage you to go ahead and share with other individuals and invite them to come on in and join us. We want you to take the time right now to put down all the other devices. Come on, turn that television off. Come off some of the other things that you may be on, and let's all focus in for the word of God on this evening. You know what we declare? Our heart's desire is to make a place and a space for the Lord. And it's Wednesday evening, 7 o'clock p.m., for our time of worship, our time of prayer, and our time of study in the Word of God. Amen? Praise God. Our scripture lesson on this evening, Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 55, Isaiah 55. And we're going to begin at verse number 6, and we're going to read all the way through verse number 12. Isaiah 55, verse number 6 through verse number 12. Hear now the word of the Lord. Speak while he may be found, or seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way. Come on, I hope you've got your Bibles open or your device, and you're joining us in reading on this evening. Amen. Verse 6, let's begin again. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his or her way, and the unrighteous man or woman their thoughts. And let them return to the Lord, and the Lord will have mercy upon him and also to our God. For he will abundantly forgive us or pardon us. Verse number 8. For my thoughts, the Lord says, are not your thoughts, nor are my ways your ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain comes down and the snow from heaven, and do not return there, but water the earth, and make it bring forth or bud forth, so that you might have bread for the eater and seed for the sower. Verse 11 says, so shall my word be, just like that rain that comes down and waters the earth, so shall my word be that goes forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void. We're getting ready to receive the word of God tonight. Amen. So shall my word be that goes forth out of my mouth. God says it will not return unto me void, but it will accomplish that which I please, and it will prosper in the thing where I have sent it. In verse number 12, for you shall go out with joy and be led out with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break forth in the singing before the Lord, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands in worship unto me. And this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Praise God. Let's go before the Lord in prayer on this evening. The Bible says in Jeremiah 3:3 that if we call upon the Lord, that God will answer us and he will show us great and mighty things which we know not of. So I want you to focus in right now and join me in these few moments of prayer as we pray for this evening, as we pray for our country so much that we need to be praying for, and as we pray for God's will to be accomplished in your life even tonight. Father, we thank you and we honor you. We bless your name, and we declare that there's none like you in all of the earth, oh God. So, Father, even tonight, we lift our voices to you. We lift our hearts to you. Come on, you that are at home, join me in doing it. We lift our voices, and we lift our hearts to you, oh God. And we cry out to you tonight, oh God. You said in your word that if we would call upon the Lord, that God, you're the one that will answer us, and you would show us great and mighty things which we know not of. So, Father, tonight, we call upon you, oh God. We call upon your hand to move in our midst, even, oh God, tonight. Even as, oh God, those that are on viewing us virtually, oh God, through this broadcast, we pray that the same anointing we sense here, they would sense it at home, oh God. For where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. There your presence is. So, Father, go into every home tonight, oh God. Minister to every person that's viewing us on tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Not only minister to them, but minister to their household, oh God, in the name of the Lord Jesus. So, Father, as we pray for our country, oh God, particularly in this season of transition, This is a season of transition, oh God. Father, you said that you cannot put new wine in old wineskins. You can't put a fresh anointing that which is old. So, Father, we thank you, oh God. Father, even, oh God, for our elect, oh God, President Biden, even tonight, we lift him up to you, oh God. We lift up the vice president. We lift up those that he's making his cabinet, or those that he's drawing around him as his cabinet. We pray, God, that you would give him wisdom for our country and for our land in this particular season. We pray for the current president, President Trump, that you would touch his heart, oh God. That, Father, he would open up his heart, oh God, to this transition, oh God, in the name of the Lord Jesus. We bind every work of the devil that would seek to hinder our country from moving on, oh God. Father, we thank you tonight that you called us your people. You said we, your people who are called by your name, if we would humble ourselves and pray and seek your face. I pray that you are praying, child of God, for this country. You said, and seek your face and turn from our wicked ways. That, God, you will hear from heaven and you will heal our land. Lord, our land needs healing. Our land needs help in this particular season, oh God. And we thank you that your word declares in Psalms 46 that you are, oh God, our very present help in times of trouble. So God, we look to you, oh God, and we declare that there's nothing too hard for God. We declare that we would not be in fear as a people and as a country, oh God, but we declare that our country is in your hands, oh God, and your desires for prosperity and peace, oh God. And we pray that in the name of the Lord Jesus, that you would bring about peace even in this season, oh God. Father, we pray for these numbers that we are seeing, oh God, that are rising, oh God, these cases, oh God. Father, we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus, you are still Lord over this virus, oh God, over this pandemic, over this sickness, oh God. And Father, we pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ that by the power of the Holy Spirit, oh God, that you would bring this virus to naught, oh God, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you even now that you give, oh God, our hospitals, our physicians, our nurses, our doctors, you give them grace and strength in this season as more are coming into the hospitals, oh God. We pray, oh God, that Father, you, oh God, would give them strength, oh God. They would not become, oh God, discouraged. Father, we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus for those that have lost loved ones, oh God. Those that are fearful in this season, oh God. Father, you said in your word that you've not given us a spirit of fear, oh God, but of power and of sound mind. Therefore, I declare peace over the people of God. I declare peace over our country. Come on, declare it over your region. Declare it over your state. Declare it over your city. Declare it over your development, your neighborhood. We declare peace over our homes, over our families, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we declare in the name of Jesus Christ that no weapon formed against this country, no weapon formed against us shall prosper in Jesus' mighty name. I declare the strength of the Lord for you, child of God, tonight in Jesus' name. For the word of God declares, greater is he, greater is the Christ that is in you than he that is in the world, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So, Father, I pray for every believer tonight that's watching, that they would not, God, be discouraged, oh God, but, Father, they would place their hope in you, oh God. We declare in the words of David, oh God, that we look unto the hills from whence cometh our help. We declare that our help and our support and our strength, oh God, comes from you, Lord. So we look to you tonight in the name, oh God, our eyes are on you, oh God. Our eyes are not on what's going on in the White House. Our eyes are not what's going on our jobs or our community. Our eyes are on you, Lord. And we thank you, oh God, that you said in your word that you would cause all things to work together for our good. We need, God, you to turn some things around tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, turn it around. Turn it around for that man, for that woman. Turn it around for that marriage, oh God, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Turn it around for that person that's trusting and believing you, Lord, for total healing. We speak healing even tonight. We bind the spirit of infirmity right now and declare by the Jesus' stripes, you are healed. Father, we thank you even now for everyone that's looking this way and believing God for healing. Touch Nicole's body tonight in the name of the Lord God Jesus. Strengthen her, oh God, tonight. Strengthen John tonight, oh God, and cause him to trust you, oh God. Father, touch Marla's body tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. And right where you are at home, begin to lift up the names of those that you know that are believing God for healing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you even now, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that you touch Reverend Johnson's, oh God, Father, hip, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for healing and total recovery tonight and strength tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus. God, we loose our ministering angels to bring hope to those that are standing on the wall, for you've declared that after we've done all the stand, to continue, Lord, to stand. And we do that tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't give up, child of God. You keep on pressing, as the Apostle Paul said, forgetting those things that are behind us. I speak the word of God over you. We declare that we will press towards the mark of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that we are not victors, but we are victorious in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We are not victims, O God, but we stand victorious before you tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. We claim it tonight. We claim it. We claim peace. We claim healing. We claim strength tonight in Jesus' name. And I speak that over your life and over your household in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Come on, put those hands together and just bless the name of the Lord. Oh, we worship you, Father. We honor you that, God, you hear our prayer and you answer our prayer in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, praise be to God. We honor the Lord for a time of prayer. Amen. And the Bible says some things only happen through prayer and also fasting. Again, thank you for joining us on this evening. We're glad that you've carved out the time to be with us tonight. Listen, I want to lift up a couple of announcements, and then we'll receive the song of the Lord. Brother Reggie's here to minister in song. And listen, we've got one of our very own on tonight, Minister Michelle Brody. She's got a word from the Lord. She's going to be coming and sharing the word of the Lord after the ministry of music on this evening. Listen, I do want to remind you of a couple things. It's already on our website, but I just want to get it in your mind, remind you of it. This coming Thursday, I'm looking for all of our men. Come on, brothers. I want us to turn out all of our men to be on with us virtually on this coming Thursday for our Zoom, a gathering at 7:30 p.m. this coming Thursday, the 19th. Dr. Buster Sorries is going to be with us on this Thursday, and he's going to be ministering from the theme Financial Freedom. Amen. In this season, we want to make sure we stay in the black. Amen. Praise God. And as we do that, we want to ask God for his wisdom, but we also want practical wisdom. Dr. Sorries, anointed man of God, has done several particular, written several books in the area of financial freedom and prosperity. And I want our men to be on to join us. Listen, men, share with another man, but I'm looking forward to, for you to be on time. You know how we do here, things here at CFC? We start on time and we finish on time this coming Thursday. But also, parents, we want to encourage you to make sure that your children join us for our children's church time. Amen. This coming Saturday at 10 o'clock a.m., all of our classes are going to be getting on at different times. Listen, you've already received the e-blast. You'll get another e-blast right in that e-blast for our men and for our children's church time. Just press that link, and it's simply going to take you right there to our Zoom session. So we want to encourage you to make sure that you are on with us. And then, of course, don't forget to join us on this coming Sunday, the Lord's Day. Listen, our worship team was in on last Sunday. They're going to be with us again this coming Sunday, and we had an awesome time in the Lord. You've got time now to begin to share and invite other individuals to join us online and hear the word of God and engage in worship with us as well. And then our final announcement, and we'll remind you on next Sunday as well, too, that next Wednesday we won't have any Bible study. It's Thanksgiving week, so we will have that time off. So we want you to be mindful of that as well, too. But we'll make sure we remind you of that as well. Again, all of the announcements, you can simply go online and get those announcements and see what's going on here at CFC. And finally, before Brother Reggie comes, I want to remind you of the importance of your tithe and your offering. I want to, first of all, thank all of you that have been faithful in the giving of your tithe and your offerings. Man, if I can begin to share the testimony of what God has done, even in this COVID season, for individuals that have been faithful tithers and liberal givers. And I want to encourage you to do the same as well, too. If you've got a PayPal account, you can simply just give on your PayPal account, or go again online to Christ Family Church, and simply there's a giving link there, and you can give of your tithes and your offerings. And then finally, I got too much to say tonight, right? Finally, listen, you all were a blessing. The Christmas Operation Christmas Child, what a blessing. Today we delivered over 114 packed boxes. Amen. Praise God. We ought to give the Lord a hand. We are doing ministry outside of the four walls of this church. And those were just the individuals that turned it in on this past Sunday. There are others of you that are taking it to other locations, but I simply want to say thank you. Thank you for heeding the word to be a blessing to families outside of yours. And I believe that God's going to return increase in your life for your faithfulness and also your giving. Somebody ought to say, I receive that in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Again, the song of the Lord, Brother Reggie, is coming. And then the next voice we'll hear that will be sharing the word of God on tonight is, again, one of our very own, Minister Michelle Brody. Come on, let's put our hands together and receive Brother Reggie as he comes to minister in song.
Good evening, Christ Family Church. Before we receive the word, we want to take the time to just proclaim and exclaim how wonderful and mighty our God is. We want to lift up holy hands and lift up our voice tonight to let him know, Lord, you are mighty. No matter what's going on in my life, we proclaim today that, Lord, you are mighty. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Oh, Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Say, Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Oh, Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Oh, Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. The song says, oh, Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. You set your glory above the heavens and the earth. When I think of all you've made, the sun, the moon, and the stars, Lord, no praise is high enough to express how great you are. We proclaim, what a mighty God. You receive all the glory. You are mighty God. We say angels bow before you. They bow before the mighty God. We proclaim what a mighty God we serve. He has all power in the palm of his hand. He's a God that cannot fail, angels. Why we say hallelujah, 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 we say all glory, all honor, all praise, all praise, we say hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You're mighty. Oh Lord, you're mighty. No matter what happens, God, we say, Lord, you're mighty. No matter how I feel, we proclaim, your Lord, you're mighty. Oh Lord, you're mighty. In the morning, God, in the evening, God, oh Lord, you're mighty. Result. Lord, Lord, you're mighty. Yes, Lord, you're mighty. Oh, Lord, you're mighty. No matter what happens, I may fail or succeed, we still say, Lord, you're mighty. Hey, oh, Lord, you're mighty. Oh, Lord, you're mighty. Oh, Lord, you're mighty. Glory, glory, glory.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. God, I just thank you for being a mighty God, an awesome God. Lord, you are mighty. I thank Brother Reggie for that song. I tell you, it just moved my heart so much. Just a reminder. It's just a reminder of what a mighty God we serve. And we have to remember that he is mighty. He's mightier than anything we could face, anything that we're going through. He is a mighty God, mighty in battle, strong God. And there is nothing too hard or too difficult for him. Amen. Let's go into a time of prayer. Father God, I just honor you tonight. I give you all the glory and all the praise, God, because you deserve it. Lord, you are mighty, and there is none like you. None can compare to you. There is none greater than you, none like you, oh God. And what a mighty God we serve. Lord, I thank you for this service on tonight. I pray, Lord, that your good and perfect will be done. Lord, I decrease that you may increase, oh God. Speak through me. Have your way and your will on tonight, oh God. And Lord, I thank you right now, Lord, for those that are listening, oh God, on tonight, that your word will go forth, oh God, with clarity and boldness, oh God, that it will change hearts and change minds, oh God. Holy Spirit, you are welcome to dwell in the midst of this service. Holy Spirit, lead me, guide me, help me, teach me. And Lord, I just thank you and I surrender it to you, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen and amen. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. To God be the glory for that song. I just thank God on tonight for being here to be able to stand before you. I thank God for life and health and strength in my body on tonight to be able to bring forth a word that I do believe that God has given to me. And actually, he dropped this word in my spirit several months ago. And I just want to share it with you on tonight. I want to take time even now to thank Pastor and First Lady, Lady Mill Wilson, for an opportunity to stand before you and to share the word with you on tonight. I give honor to Pastor Wilson and First Lady on tonight. And I just thank God for an opportunity to bring you what I believe the Lord has given to me on tonight. Won't be before you long, so we're going to get started. We're going to turn to Daniel 6, Daniel chapter 6, if you'll go with me there. And tonight we're going to talk a little bit about Daniel and some of the things that Daniel persevered through. You know, Daniel ended up being a very prosperous prophet. He went through quite a bit of challenges and obstacles, but yet Daniel decided to just continue to keep moving in the things that he knew to do and in the word of God, because he knew that God was with him. And that's one of the things that I want us to take away tonight. Just keep moving, because we know that God is with us. So again, I'm going to read quite a bit of Daniel because I want us to really get the understanding of where I want to go with this message. So again, Daniel chapter 6, I'm going to start with verse 10, the reading of the word. Now when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went into his house, and his windows being opened in his chamber towards Jerusalem, he kneeled upon his knees 3 times a day and prayed and gave thanks before his God as he did aforetime. Then these men assembled and found Daniel praying and making supplication before his God. Then they came near and spake before the king concerning the king's decree. Hast thou not signed a decree that every man that shall ask a petition of any god or man within 30 days, save of thee, O king, shall be cast into the den of lions? The king answered and said, The thing is true, according to the law of the Medes and the Persians, which altered not. So that means the law can't change. Then answered they and said before the king, that Daniel, which is of the children of the captivity of Judah, regardeth not thee, O king, nor the decree that thou hast signed, but maketh his petition 3 times.